Before starting the video, I would like to tell you something about ipsguide.com. In their website, they provide a daily free question which help you to boost your preparation either for banking or SSC examination. Also, you can check out their test series which has high standard question with a detailed solution, and at the end of each test, we provide with smart analysis that how well you performed, which are the area you must work on, and also test series are available in both language, that is Hindi as well as English. It is accessible on both desktop as well as mobile app, whichever suits on you. For more information, you can visit estore.ipsguide.com. Now let's move toward our video.
Hello everyone. Today it's day 47 for SBI PO preparation 2019. Okay, so today we have a puzzle related to distance and direction, but very new puzzle. We have matrix in it, okay? And before proceeding to other question, I would like to request you all, please do subscribe to our channel and do share it with your friends. And if you enjoy the video, do like it. And please visit www.ipsguide.com for the study materials related to banking or SSC. So let's move towards our question. So here's the question. First, you should pause the video and try to do it yourself. First, you should pause it, okay? Only then you should come to the solution. Okay, now let's see the solution here. What we have? We have a matrix, okay? The given grid represents the roadmap of seven cities: Jaipur, Haryana, Lucknow, Rajasthan, Goa, Gurugram, and Kolkata. Each city is located at different point as shown in the figure. Okay, so we have here seven points and we have seven cities, but we don't know where the city is, okay? Which city belongs to which point, okay? Now see what we have. All the distance calculated were the minimum distance between them. The only mode to travel between cities is along the grid lines. So what it actually means, if you have to travel from A to B, from A to B, you should travel like this. From here, you should go here, then you should go here, okay? Like this, okay? If you want to move to C, so you have to take the shortest distance, okay? So how can you go? You can go like this, this and this, okay? Clear? This, this and this. Clear? And what they are saying, each grid, that is 1:1, that grid, okay, this one, just take a example of this grid. This is 100:100. What it is 100:100. Clear? So what they want to represent, or what they want to say you, that if you travel from A to B like this, okay, so you will travel distance of 100 plus 100 plus 100 plus 100, that is 400. Clear? Got my points? What I want to say you? Okay, what I want to make you understand. Clear? Now see what they have. The cities can be reached by traveling along the grid lines shown in the diagram. The shaded area represents the restricted area, that is one cannot travel along the vertical corners and grid line bordering passing through the areas. What it actually means? So if this is the shaded region, okay, and you have to travel from A to F, from A to F, you can't go up because it is shaded area, so you can't use this point. You can't even use this point, okay? And you can't go there, and you can't go there, okay? So how you can travel A to F? You have to go like this, this and this, and then you have to reach there, okay? Like this. Clear? You can't move along the bordered areas, okay? Or shaded areas. Clear? Now see the information and let's proceed to our question. Now see what we have. The shortest route between Jaipur and Rajasthan is 200, okay? Jaipur and Rajasthan is 200. So which points are just 200 kilometer away? Let's see. A and E are 200 kilometers away because we have to travel from A to this line and to this line. Okay, 100 and 100, 200. B to E or B to E. Clear? There are no any other points we can use for these two. Okay. So what actually it means? Okay, Rajasthan can be point A. Okay, because then E can be Jaipur. Rajasthan can be E because A can be Jaipur and B can be Jaipur. If you use B as Rajasthan, okay, B as Rajasthan, then E must be Jaipur, okay? Clear? Got my points? So from here you concluded three things: that Rajasthan, okay, the Rajasthan can be point A, can be point B, and can be point E, okay? Now see the this point, that is point number 5, okay? This point number 5 is not point E, is not Rajasthan. Got my point? Point E is not Rajasthan. So this means Rajasthan can only be A or B. So E can't be there. Okay. So it means we have two possibilities. Rajasthan can be in the A. Rajasthan can be here and Rajasthan can be in B. Clear? Got my points or not? Clear? Now see, if you take A as Rajasthan, then you must take E as Jaipur. Okay. If you take A as Rajasthan, E must be taken as Jaipur. Got my point? Now, if you take B as Rajasthan, then you must take another, or you can say you can take E as Jaipur as well. Okay. Because there is no other point which can be 200 meter away from B, 200 kilometer away from B. So it means in any case, okay, in any case, that is case number one or case number two, Jaipur must be on point number E. That is fixed. That is fixed. E is Jaipur. Okay. E is Jaipur. Clear? Got the points or not? Got the points? Clear? Now see what we have next. Now see that Rajasthan is equidistant from Haryana and Goa. Okay. Rajasthan is equidistant from Haryana and Goa. So what it actually want to say that if you take case A, that is point A is Rajasthan. So there must be two points who are equidistant from A. Okay. There must be two points who are equidistant from A and that must be Haryana and Goa. So E can't be that point. Okay. Because we already know that E is Jaipur. So I am taking first case first. Okay. I am taking case number first. So if I calculate the distance between A and B, that is 1, 2, 3 and 4. So you have to travel like this 1, 2, 3 and 4. So between A and B, there is this gap of 400 kilometer. But there is no other point that is 400 kilometer away from A. Just see that. If you take the point C, okay, okay, so it means B can't be that point. Okay, you can't make the B as Haryana or Goa. So, okay, now next, what we can have? One, okay, that is one grid, that is second grid, that is third, that is four, that is five, and that is six. So from A to six, we have to travel 600 kilometer. Okay, now see, is there any point which is 600 kilometer from A other than C? Now see, D can't be 600 because if you travel 400 up to B, then 500, then 600, then 700, and then 800. So distance between A and D must be 800. Okay, this is the distance between A and C, and between A and D, that is 800. Okay, now from A to G, it must be greater than 800 because you have to travel from here, okay, then D, then you have to reach G. Now see A to F, now you can see one grid, second grid, third, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Got my point? Now see, distance between AD and AF is 800. It means there are only two points which are equidistant from point A. So according to case 1, we can conclude that D and F must be Haryana or Goa. Thick. Okay. So you can put D as Haryana or Goa. Haryana or Goa. I'm not confirming them, but I know that D or F can only be Haryana and Goa. You can't put any other state, thick, or any other city here. Okay. Now let's see case number two. For case number two, B is Rajasthan. Okay. So distance between B and E, that is 200, but E can't be Haryana or Goa because E is already Jaipur. So, okay. So now see B to A, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So B to A, we have 400. Okay. Now B to D, 1, 2, 3, 4. B to D. Okay. Now B to D is, we have 400. Okay. B to D, we have 400. Got my points or not? Clear? Now see, we can also check other points also. Now see B to C, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6. So B to C is 600 and B to G, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So B to G, we have 800. Okay. And now B to F, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Okay, so it means there are only two points which are equidistant from B. That is point A and D. So it means and D, only A and D can be Haryana and Goa. Okay, only A and D can be Haryana and Goa for case number 2. So you can put A as Haryana and Goa. Haryana and Goa. Okay, and D as Haryana and Goa. Got my points or not? Clear? Everything is clear or not? Just focusing. Keep focusing on what I am saying. Okay. Now see what we have next. Now see, the shortest distance between Lucknow and Haryana is 800. Okay. Distance between Lucknow and Haryana is 800. Clear? Now see, Haryana in case number 1. In case number 1, Haryana can be D. Okay. And Haryana can be F. Haryana can be F. Clear? Got my points? Now see, from D, do you have any point which is 800 kilometer away? Now see, B can't be there. Okay, B is 1, 2, 3, 400. Theek hai? E cannot be there and A is already fixed, that is Rajasthan. So we have left with only points we are left with, that is G. Okay, G and C. So first, we have to check up to G. So 1, 2, 3, 4. This is not possible. Okay. If you are taking D as Haryana, okay, then G is not possible. And if you are taking D as Haryana, then checking the C. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So from point D, if you are taking D as Haryana in case number 1, okay, if you are taking D as Haryana, there is no point which is 800 kilometer away, which is 8 kilometer 100 away. So it means, what we calculated from here, that in case number 1, in case number 1, D can't be Haryana. D can't be Haryana. So it means F must be Haryana. F must be Haryana. So we have to now check which point is 800 kilometer away from F. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So C is 800 kilometer away from F. Okay. Now see, you can even say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, E is also 800. But E is already fixed with Jaipur na. So it means if you are taking F as Haryana in case number 1, then you must take C as Lucknow. Okay. And this is the only possibility we have. So it means F must be Haryana, D must be Goa, and it means C must be Lucknow. Okay. This is for case 1. Now see for case number 2. If you are taking A as Haryana, if you are taking A as Haryana, okay. So you have to find out a point that is 800 kilometer away from A. Okay. So what are the possibility? Okay. What are the possibility? The points we have left is, that is point number C and point F and G. Okay. So first see about G. So for reaching G, we must go like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So there is no possibility that you can reach from A to G in 800. So G is also gone. Okay. If you are taking A as Haryana. Okay. If you are taking A as Haryana. Now other possibility we have, that F or C. So for F, for C. So first we check for C. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So A to C is 600. Okay. A to C is 600. So this is not possible. Now A to F. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it is possible in case number 2nd that A is Haryana. Okay. A is Haryana and F is Lucknow. And F is Lucknow. Okay. Now we have to check other possibility too. That is D can be Haryana. D can be Haryana. Okay. D can be Haryana. So if D is Haryana, okay. Now check. Is there any point which is 800 kilometer away from D? And we have already checked it in case number 1. We have already checked it in case number 1 that there is no point which is 800 kilometer away from D. We can again check it. That is 1, 2, 3, that is 4, 5, 6, okay, that is 7 and that is 8. But A is already given to Haryana or Goa in case number 2. Okay, so this is not possible. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, this is not possible. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, this is not possible. And up to C, it is also not possible. So it means D can't be Haryana in any case. Okay. For case number 2, there is no possibility that in case number 2, D can be Haryana. So it means A must be Haryana. D must be Goa. D must be Goa. And F must be Lucknow. Okay, F must be Lucknow. Got my points? Now we have this point, we have this point. Now see, we have Gurugram and Goa is 400. Gurugram and Goa is 400. So in case number 1, D is Goa. D is Goa. So we have to take 400. So 400 can be 1, 2, 3, 4. G can be Gurugram. Okay. Or 1, 2, 3, 4. B can be Gurugram. So there is two possibility. So we will check it in later. Let's check the case number 2. If Goa is D. Okay. If Goa is D. But B can't be Gurugram because it is already Rajasthan. So it means in case number B, Gurugram must be G. Gurugram. Now only we have left now, that is Lucknow and Kolkata must be 600. Lucknow and Kolkata must be 600. So Lucknow in case number 1, Lucknow is C. Case number 1. So if Lucknow is C, okay, Lucknow is C. So we have to check which point is 600 km from point C. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That is point A, but A is already Rajasthan. So 4 up to E, then 5 and then 6. Okay. So only possibility we have left for case number 1, that Lucknow, if Lucknow is C point, then B must be Kolkata. If B is Kolkata, it means G must be Gurugram in this case. And now in this case, if you are saying Lucknow is F, if you are saying Lucknow is F, okay, and you are saying in this case C must be, let me check, Haryana is done, Rajasthan is done, Goa, Jaipur, Lucknow and Gurugram. So we have left with Kolkata, okay, Kolkata. But the distance between Lucknow and Kolkata must be 600, okay. For case 2, Lucknow is F, okay, and Kolkata is C. So check whether they are 600 km away. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. They are 800. So it means case number 2 is not possible. So the our answer will be case number 1. This is the perfect arrangement of these points. Okay. Point A will be Rajasthan, B will be Kolkata, C will be Lucknow, D will be Goa, E will be Jaipur, F will be Haryana, and G will be Gurugram. Got my points? Clear or not? Now let's proceed toward the questions. So here are the questions we have. So first we have, which of the following city is at point C? So at point C we have Lucknow. So answer will be option number D. What is the minimum distance between point B and Haryana? So point B and Haryana is point F. Haryana is point F. So we need to take the minimum. Okay, we need to take the minimum. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Okay, so this is the minimum distance, because if you go through 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is not possible that it will be minimum. So minimum will be this line. Okay, so it means 1000 kilometer. Clear? Now third question we have. If Ramu has to travel from Goa to Haryana, just remove this one first. Okay. Now, if Ramu has to travel from Goa to Haryana via Kolkata, so Goa is D. Okay. Goa is D. Haryana is F and Kolkata is B. So you have to go from D to F via B. Okay. Then what is the minimum distance? So first of all, you have to go from D to this point. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. That is 1400 kilometer. Answer number E. Okay. Now fourth question. What says? If it takes 6 hours, if it takes 6 hours to travel from point C to Kolkata. So from C to Kolkata, we have B. From C to B, we have taken 6 hours. Then what is the time required to traveling from point Gurugram to F? Okay, now first see, from C to B, what is the distance from C to B? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. That is 600 kilometer. So we are covering 600 kilometer in 6 hours. Okay, so it means we are covering 100 kilometer in 1 hour. So we have to go from point C, okay, no, from Gurugram to point F. So where is Gurugram? Gurugram is point G. Okay, from point G to point F. So we have to travel like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. We have to travel 600 kilometer. And each 100 kilometer takes 1 hour. So 600 kilometer will take 6 hours. So option number B. And last we have, which of the following city is at point G? So at point G we have Gurugram. That is option number C. So that's all what we have for today. Hope you enjoy the video. If you really like our video, don't forget to press the like button and do share it with your friends. This is latest pattern, new pattern, okay? And do subscribe to our channel and don't forget to press the bell icon for the latest notification of the videos. And please visit www.ibpsguide.com for the study materials. Thank you so much.